Unlocked the bonus menu. I heard a little about this. Apparently there's like some extra scenes and stuff we can see here. Naturally, we are going to check them out. And I guess there's like, was the gallery already here? I don't know. Here's the music list. There's all the songs. Woo wee. There's a locked song? Oh, how curious. How about that? Let's look at the gallery real quick. Here's the fountain scene. I can push the button to see next ones. There she is in her vest. Mm-hmm. Sewing up the thing. Those dorky glasses. Literature club. Crying against his shoulder. Mm-hmm. Alright, there's all of them. Are there any locked ones, though? Nah, they're all here. Okay. Yeah, that's it for that. Yeah, I guess we'll just go right for it. Bonus. There's a whole bunch of them. Wow. Parallels and alternates. So wait, what's... Yeah, we'll start from the top, I guess. Let's go here. Parallel 1. Street Spirit. Thursday, 28th of September. I blink once, twice, thrice. I try to process what she said. Suicide. The puzzle clicks into place. Her behavior, her absence. Hallie's reaction and excuses. Oh, is this like Monica's perspective or... He tried to cover it up as best he could. A partial success. Monica had no idea, at least. Alright, no, it can't be, then. But I figured it might have been something like this. Oh, she's staring. I'm guessing we're Yuri.
I should say something. All right. Gah. Why can I not say something, anything of substance? I don't know. Siri looks at me blankly for but a moment. Then quietly giggles. Laughing? Oh no. I have to apologize right now. Do it. I'm so sorry. Words going by so quickly. That was so...
What? You're fine. I was just thinking if everyone's reaction is going to be like that, then today's going to be a heck of a lot easier than I thought.
I apologize.
I actually really appreciate it. Low-key response, I mean. You aren't going into, like, freak-out mode. That's what I was afraid of.
Afraid of? You are afraid of others' reactions? She nods.
It's just because I need to tell people, sure, but nobody needs to worry about me other than me, you know? It'll just make me feel worse, knowing that it'll ruin someone else's day. I can handle my own issues. And the less people who worry, the better. Does that make sense?
Her statement strikes a chord, a feeling of which I know all too well. The scarred flesh on my arm seems to pulsate with my heartbeat, providing a burning, familiar itch. A problem that she is at war with inside her head, manifesting into the physical. Something deep within feels elated. I'm not alone. But do I? I find my mouth opening before I can think. I can sympathize. In more ways than one.
Hmm?
Do I do this? Is this even appropriate? Siri's a friend, granted, but with how she opened up just now. I glance over at her. As I finally meet her eyes, that same something deep within wrenches once more. A desire to finally connect with someone who could understand. Someone who's also been at the blackest brink. Someone who'd know not to go into hysterics at the mere mention. A friend. If it's anybody. Can I be confident in your discretion?
Hmm? What?
I meant, can you keep a secret between us?
Oh, yeah, of course!
It's okay to be vulnerable. I breathe in. This will help her, I think. You're aware that I have a sizable collection of knives, yes?
Yeah, the cool knives!
Yes, those. They're not entirely for decoration.
Hmm?
I swallow my own uncertainty and mentally piece together my response. I keep them sharp and clean, but because sometimes I'll nick the blade into my skin. Enough to draw blood. I'm long past the point of no return. In for a penny, in for a pound. I used to do this on my arms, but they're too noticeable. I didn't want anybody to see them. I still don't. So I switched to the top of my thighs. I try to keep it under the control, and I'm managing a lot better now. But I used to think that this was all because of anxiety or some sort of fetish. And now, I think somewhere inside, subconsciously, I wished to feel pain. I can't say I particularly enjoy the sensation, quite the opposite, in fact. But it's as if I deserve to feel it anyway. Sayori remains quiet, arms folded in her lap, gazing forward at her shoes. I went too far. I ruined it. I didn't mean to make this all about myself. I thought I'd tell you because you might feel similarly. Perhaps you might find some comfort in the fact that you're not alone. That you aren't alone in the way you're feeling, I mean. And that everything changes eventually. Not always for the better, but things do change. It's the nature of life itself. When you sought out the help you needed, it was the first step to that change. And it's something to look forward to. I think that's the only comfort I can provide. But without lying to you, I run out of figurative steam, pausing myself before I trail off into nonsense. Sayori takes a deep breath. I feel her arms wrap around me. My nerves recoil at the sudden touch, and I briefly reconsider backing away. But I think she needs this. And for once, my touch repulsion softens. We stay like this for a minute or two before I feel her pull back. She speaks up.
Thank you. That couldn't have been easy for you to talk about.
It wasn't.
I'm sorry.
Please don't be. I don't imagine yours was any easier.
Yeah. But hey, you're right that it's not gonna really be rainbows and puppies, but lying isn't what I need right now anyway. But I really do appreciate it, Yuri. I'm just glad somebody else just gets it. Someone who sees it for how it is.
Sayori looks down at her feet, clacking her shoes together aimlessly for a moment. Her hands lie limp in her lap.
It still hurts. It hurts every time to think about it and talk about it. And today is going to hurt a lot. But my friends deserve to know.
What are you planning on telling them?
Probably as soon as everyone gets here. Even though I know people like you and Hallie are going to be supportive of it, none of that makes me any less worried.
Well, I just want to let you know. I'll be there for you. Sayori hides her emotions well, most of the time. I'm sure nobody was aware of what was going on beneath the surface. But even I can see how she's feeling now. That feeling primarily being sheer and utter dread. I can tell from her expression, her eyes shrunk to what seems to have no end, her mouth quivering into a frown. Knowing that my attempt at comforting her somewhat failed miserably, I steel myself and attempt again. Listen. You don't have to listen to me or anyone else about what to do. But no matter what, just know that whatever you choose is entirely up to you. Her eyes close for a moment.
For once, yeah, it is. And it feels good. But...
she turns towards me again.
Things can change.
They always can, whether by your own forces or those outside us. A small nod from her, then a sigh.
That's a nice thought. Cause, like, I feel like Kelly, my mom, they haven't ever seen this before and they're just assuming the worst. Like I'm a nutcase or something. And I'm not, like, fine, but I'm doing better. Like, somewhere in the middle, you know? And I hope that'll change someday soon.
I suppose that makes two of us then. A small smile escapes her as she turns her head to meet my gaze once more. I instinctively evade eye contact.
Guess so.
The ensuing silence envelops us. There's a dark feeling brewing beneath, but I swallow it back down. I can't let down my demeanor in front of her, in front of anyone. I will handle it later. Right now, I need to say something. I attempt once again to provide some level of comfort. We haven't kept in good contact as of late, have we?
Yeah, we haven't. I'm bad at the whole responding to people's messages thing. I still appreciate that letter you sent me, though. I just... kind of lost it.
Well, don't worry about that for now. I don't find myself initiating much conversation, truth be told. Sometimes I don't even remember my phone exists. But I always have it on, so... You can always reach out to me if you need something. I may not respond all the time, but... I am but a message away. I take my phone out and gently wave it. As soon as I do, Siri snorts and laughs loudly.
Yeah, you and that dinosaur!
What?
2000 Blade called and wants its phone back! I can't believe you still own a flip phone! How do you even use that thing?
It's affordable and reliable. I have no need for a touchscreen or constant internet access.
What? You don't have internet on your phone? How do you not get bored? I'd go crazy!
I do nothing but simply tap my open bag, where the black cover of the portrait of Markov protrudes.
Oh, right. You know, I try my best with that stuff. It's just so easy to stay on my phone all the time and endlessly scroll.
It's a massive time sink, you know. A constant distraction.
But Yuri! There's so many cats!
I'm no Luddite, Siri. I have a laptop at home. But I find that a smartphone takes up a lot of time and energy. Hence why I try to avoid it. It's not really healthy to... A cough from the front of the room startles me.
Oh, Hilly!
Startled, I look up to see Hilly sheepishly waving, setting down his bag. How long was he there for? He's followed by Natsuki, who... seems to be without her school blazer. Curious. I quickly head back to my desk by the corner, stuffing my bag beneath my arm.
How long have you been here?
Just arrived. Everything okay?
I don't respond. A wave of shame washes over me. I didn't even greet Hally or Natsuki. Why am I always like this? Always unable to strike up a conversation. Siri even had to push me to talk to her today. I'm glad we did. I certainly feel a bit better about my own issues. But I feel so tired, fatigued, and drained. I feel eyes staring at me. I don't dare to look back, instead pulling out the portrait of Markov from my bag. Natsuki waves to Siri before disappearing into the closet.
Yeah, everything's good!
While trying to find my place, I sneak a glance at the front of the room. Hally and Siri seem to be in quiet conversation. I wonder if he knows the extent of what Siri's internal turmoil truly is. A silly thought in retrospect. He has to know, at least on some sort of level. Either way, it's up to Siri now. I think she'll end up following through with her plan. But the emotional response from the rest of our members. My muscles tense up again. Part of me wants to be there as a show of respect, or support, rather, but I think back to what Siri told me about how she just wants us to move past it. Perhaps it's better if I stay here. If she needs me, I have no doubt that she'll let me know. Until then, I need to limit my involvement, lest I induce a stress headache or, worse, a panic attack. That's the last thing any of us needs right now. Keep calm and read my book. I tune the world out, relax my muscles, breathe. Let the world or let the words flow through me. Now,
what about me?
Monica's sudden appearance at the door wrenches me out of my meditation. Her voice is loud and demanding, startling me enough to snap me out of my thoughts. It means it's about to start. If it starts. I feel that creeping tension once more. A feeling of breathing in humid air on a hot summer's day. A faint trembling in my fingers.
Actually, Monica, I think it'd be easier to just address it now.
I hear Monica talking. Then Hally. And then Siri interrupts. I see Natsuki slink away. Then Monica again. My hyper-awareness is like a radio that I can't turn off. Should I be up there? Should I keep away? What am I expected to do? I don't know. I try to focus myself once more, to ease my mind back into the page. Slow breaths. In. Out. Once more, the world is blocked out. And I slip into my trance. sudden sound to my left. I gasp and jerk my head around. Natsuki, eyes wide and skin pale, is taking a seat at a corner desk. I make eye contact with Sayori. Her expression is... I stand up and head towards Natsuki. Why am I doing this? I'm so drained, exhausted. That talk with Sayori depleted any energy I had for social interactions today. Besides, deep inside, I'm scared that she will yell at me. That she will not want me around. But... Natsuki is my friend. She, at least, needs to know I care. Without attracting too much attention, I creep my way towards Natsuki in a half-crouch. I kneel down next to her. She doesn't seem to acknowledge me. Natsuki? She opens her eyes, staring me down. Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
I doubt that she's at all fine. Even so, you can... I trail off. What am I even doing? I'm already overextending as it is. I'm making a fool out of myself.
Thanks, I guess. I mean it. It's nice of you. But yeah, no, I'm good. It's heavy stuff, but I can handle it on my own. Seriously.
As long as you're sure, then I'll let you be. But the offer always stands. You have my number, I think.
I don't know. I might. I mean, I can just get it off Hallie either way if I need to.
I see. I'm sorry to bother you. I can feel the animosity. Dallas, she still carries some level of grudge for the things I've said previously. But I've gotten my message across. I came off as stilted and unnatural, but that's a secondary concern. I can only nod awkwardly and stand up to leave. I feel a hand grasp my forearm.
Yuri, wait!
I pause and kneel back down.
Can you just...
stay here for a second? Oh, of course.
Just... yeah.
We're there in silence for a minute or two. Natsuki boring holes into the desk with her stare. Myself, beside her, a silent company. If anything, this has gotten my mind away from what's happening in front of the room. Though, I do worry about how Sayori is doing. And a part of me wonders how Hallie, her sole confidant up until now, is handling this news. Likely better than I am, though that's not precisely a high bar. I find myself scratching my arm nervously. Turning around, I see Sayori sitting at her desk, writing something down in her notebook. Out of the corner of my eye, I can see the faint shape of Hallie approaching down the aisle of desks. Satisfied that Natsuki won't be alone, I nod to Hallie and head towards Sayori. I'd feel slightly better talking to her. I think I salvaged that moment with Natsuki, but I can't take much more risk today. I take a seat next to Sayori.
Hey, Yuri!
Her shoulders sag, and she doesn't look at me. I take it the conversation didn't fare well.
It was just what needed to be said. Nothing else.
She sniffs and wipes her eyes with her sleeve. Would you like some company? I can't exactly talk too much right now, but... Sayori seems to look past me, towards Hallie and Natsuki before going back to her notebook.
Yeah. I need to jot down some notes for my therapy. So I'll be quiet anyway.
I nod, and quietly move my desk closer to her. I open my book once again.
And thanks, Yuri, for being here.
It's no problem. Her presence allows my stress to slowly melt away. A mutual understanding between us, a shared struggle, provides an odd form of comfort. I find myself falling into my book much easier this time. And for the first time today, I find a moment of peace. So that's what happened to the prisoners. That's inhuman, inhumane, grisly. It makes me ponder about some of the more macabre aspects of my history lessons. I can only wonder if this was inspired by the... My thought is interrupted by Sayori prodding me on the arm.
Hey, Yuri, before I go.
She looks away and shakes her head.
I'll need to be alone for a while. Hallie is probably taking this kind of hard. I know they've been hanging out a lot recently, but if Nuts goes without him, would you be able to walk him home?
Instantly, my limbs seize up. I've recovered somewhat since earlier, but this is so sudden. You want me to...
He doesn't bite, I promise.
But
I know this isn't really down your alley, but I'm really worried. This is a big favor to ask, and normally I wouldn't. But right now, I just need to go home and scrub this all out.
I find myself torn. I can't let Sayori down. Not today. But I don't know if I can handle this. I can try.
That's all I ask. Thanks, Siri. I'll owe you a big one.
But what if I...
It's not hard. Just make some conversation. You'll listen to anything.
She picks up her bag, slinging it over her shoulder. Like what?
I mean literally anything. He nods along with whatever I talk about half the time.
She glances at her phone.
Close about 10. Gotta see if Armani's okay, then I'm out.
Okay. Take care, won't you?
Of course. I'll be fine. Don't worry about me.
She sneaks one last glance at Hallie before heading over to Monica's desk. As I'm putting away my book, I can only think about my task ahead. Why am I like this? It seems that it's the third time I've had to ask this question today. As if I have an answer beyond I'm an abnormal. And the fact that I'm attracted to him. No, that's not helping. I need to keep a cool head. I'm doing this for Sayori. Hallie is a friend. Talk to him like Sayori. If I can handle that today...